You don't like the six-man boats, huh?
One, two, three.
I trust you with a girl, that's why. Oh.
Do we have five lines? What do we got?
I don't
know. Rows of six, please. Starting from the left, fill in, going south. So my last row should have four paddlers. So six on this first line, six in the second line,
yeah.
Six in the third line, four in the last line. Make sense?
Yep.
Let's spread out a little bit. Let's spread out a little bit. All right, so it looks like we got four over here. We need two people from this line to move over. There you go. It's like that whole math thing. Who showed up late? This line only has four in it. All right, we're getting close. There's six. Okay, fill in.
We're good. Don't go anywhere. Just stay here.
Stay here, Ray. Yeah, you're good, Ray.
You're up to six. I'm here, Ray.
All right, we're missing somebody over here. We're missing somebody over here. What's going on? Oh, we're good. Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
All right. How's everybody doing this morning? Good. Thank you for those that got started moving boats around. That's the plan. We're trying to be on the water 2 minutes from now, typically. Yeah. We'll get better at that as the season goes on, I'm sure. Introductions. Anybody here first time paddling with us? I don't think so. Very good. Okay. We're going to go. First thing we're going to do is we're going to go over safety. We had a little bit of a collision on Thursday's practice. We're in tight quarters. We're doing sprints. And I thought the guidance was clear, making a left turn. As soon as you finish the sprint, first boat starts turning, all the other boats behind will turn. That way we avoid collisions. In a scenario where the boats are...
10 times this year.
Yeah.
Never again.
In a scenario where the...
Sidetrack.
Say again, I'm sorry.
Sidetrack.
We were a little bit distracted. We were a little bit distracted. I will say that. If you were here, you know what we're talking about. If you weren't, well, you missed out. So real quick, let's just talk about rules of the road. Who's responsible for our canoes when we go out on the water? Aside from me.
Everybody.
Everybody. Yeah, exactly. Good deal. All right. Who's the team captain?
Steersman,
right? Who would you say is our second in command, for lack of a better term?
Stroker.
That's right. All right, so it's up to all of us to pay attention, but I, you know, ultimately responsibility falls on the steersperson and the stroker combined. We want to avoid, sorry, John, go ahead.
Let me go ahead and add the steersman, or excuse me, the stroker is the safety officer.
There you go.
In this case.
Right, so we all want to be mindful. I get it. We were kind of in that like Neanderthal state trying to catch our breath. We all weren't paying attention. And we had a little bump, and we need to avoid those types of things moving forward. And we'll talk about some expectations a little bit later. To recap Thursday's practice, does anybody have anything they want to say about Thursday?
Yeah, our boat started moving as soon as that chick flashed us. Man.
Okay. Okay.
The old guys got off.
Our boat started moving pretty good too, if you look
who
at the data.
Who was that club?
Yeah. The numbers don't lie, so I agree with Bill. All right. Cool. Is anybody sore from Thursday? I'm pretty sore. I'm not going to lie. Okay, cool. So everybody knows what's happening Tuesday, correct?
Yeah.
Scrimmage, Tuesday. We went over the course this past Tuesday for our workout, right? We did it's inside the bay. Everything's inside the bay. So Tuesday will be the scrimmage. Show up early. Let's make sure we get the boat set up. Max participation. Ideal. That would be ideal. We get everybody here. Let's discuss the hammer. This is what's up for grabs. It's the Hammers of Hano Hano Award. There will be an award ceremony. This award is up for grabs every time we have a scrimmage. When are we going to have scrimmages? Tuesday before each race. That's right. So bragging rights internally inside the club. So, you know, if you were in the Golden Masters and you won this award for the first time, then you'd be a plank owner. But that means that the next time we scrimmage, that award is going to go up for grabs for the next crew. So you're not safe. Make sure you show up. Protect your award. Any questions on that? All right. Let's discuss the metronome. So today, can everybody hear me? Okay. So today we're going to be focusing on a nice, easy day, right? Nice, easy. We're going to go long, but it's going to be easy. We should be in zone, heart rate zone 2. So you should be able to carry on a conversation. You should be able to accept inputs about coaching from the more experienced paddlers in your boats. And the stroke rate is going to be roughly around like a 56 or so. We're really going to lean heavily on our strokers today to keep us honest. We want constant pressure, and we want a rate that everybody in the boat at some point or another can connect and really feel that power band. We're going to go over what our ideal stroke rate is for a race or a competition. Anybody familiar with this song? This one's for John. Mustang Sally. No? Not feeling it? Britney Spears fans? What do you think these songs all have in common?
64 beats.
60. That's right. 60. It's a metronome beat of 60 beats per minute. All of those songs. So why is that important? Well, personally, all our Garmin watches have a metronome on it. Have you guys ever played with that before? So it's got a very, you know, unique tone. Try listening to that for an hour. It's boring as all hell, right? But it works. Gets you in that mindset, you know. Working efficient, keeping a stroke rate that's constant. Sometimes we'll get in our heads, especially in these longer pieces, right? So a metronome keeps you on pace. Personally, I like taking out a little waterproof speaker and listening to music on the water when I'm focusing on stroke. So if I set that metronome up and, you know, find your own plane, there's a ton. All you have to do is Google 60 beat per minute metronome. Online, download that whole playlist to your iPad or whatever you go out in the water with your phone. Very helpful for guys in a one-man. Today, we're not going to play around with this on the ocean. I just want everybody to get in that mindset. When we're racing, that ideal metronome is going to be right around 60, especially in these light boats. These light boats really like a very purposeful stroke, right? So everybody entering at the same time, pool, same time, exit, same time. Right, we start going fast in these boats, right? If we just, let's say we go up to a metronome that's above 72 beats per minute, it just gets ugly and sloppy. The boat will start to bounce because when we're in that kind of quick rate, what ends up happening is we lose our connections with the holes, right? So if you hear somebody say, hey, connect the bodies, what that really means is, or hips, what that really means is like lock yourself into the boat You know, what I like to do if there isn't a foot brace available is I'll put one foot down on the deck and then I'll push on my foot with my other foot, and that gives me a little bit more leverage. That's what we're talking about. We want to stay connected, right? You might be in the water, but you're not transferring that energy to the hull of the canoe. And so we talked a little bit about like moving as one unit, right? Hinging at the hips, one unit, moving forward. What do you think that does if six guys in a boat goes like this, all at the same time? It's gonna scoot that boat forward, right? Now you add that blade in the water, what's happening? Even more accentuates that. We're getting the boat to go forward. We don't want the boat to go up. We don't want it to go down. We want it to go forward. So that's what that movement is, right? Everybody tracking? Didn't lose anybody? Okay, good. I don't want to get too much into technique today. I want you guys to go out and just experience it, follow each other, get used to timing. But there is one thing that I do want to mention, and that's I want you to think about the stroke and how you're breathing. This is very important. We got to get oxygen to our muscles, right? And so if you're sitting upright and you're going to breathe correctly, think about this, right? So the stroke goes up. Exhale. So as we're moving forward, every time that top hand comes down, that's where you should be. Exhale. You want to feel pressure on that top hand, so much pressure that you almost can't stand it, right? Boom, coming all the way through until you exit the water. Nice even pressure, not choke pressure up front, little bit pressure here and come out weak. Even pressure throughout the whole stroke. That way the canoe doesn't go this way and that way, and the steersman's having to make all these corrections. Another thing that's important, you think about your top arm and your bottom arm. Think about this sledgehammer. We want that bottom arm straight and the top arm above it. If you're paddling like this, can everybody see? If you're paddling like this or like this from the canoe, what that does, and you'll learn this in the V1, when you have an opportunity to paddle a V1, is it changes the direction of the hull. So if I paddle like this, I'm pushing the hull this way, right? Because my body is twisting. But if I'm paddling like this, it's going straight, it's going forward, it's going in that direction. Steersman doesn't have to make that many corrections. You keep that hull speed up. If you're cruising around at 8 knots, and the steersman stops paddling because he's got to make a correction, he or she, what do you think that speed drops down to?
7 knots.
Yeah, roughly, right? Maybe 7.5. It really depends on the weight of the steers person, how fast the boat, if the boat's on a glide or if it's already kind of in a trough. But it greatly affects the hull speed. And then we all have to work harder to get it back up on that plane. Once we get it on a plane, pretty easy to keep it there. You just got to add a little bit, just keep it there. Boom, you feel it drop out, that's when we build on the power again to get it up on a plane. So we're gonna go out and play with that today. I will mention one last thing. When we're working on our starts, I'll talk about the workout soon, but when we start today, I want you to think about this metronome.
Now greetings to the world, voice of the one big gangzilla alongside Skrillex, Symphono! Ooh-wee! Awo!
We must up the pace, turn up the pace and make them all have fun. How we ablaze the fire, make it fun them. We must up the pace, turn up the pace and make some sound, boy run. And we will end your week just like...
How fast you think that was? 50? It's actually 72 beats per minute. 72 beats per minute is where we want to start, guys. Even in these light bulbs. Two sides. You want to have that. Just starting from no speed, get that hull speed up and just boogie. Two sides, right? What's two sides, roughly? Yeah, exactly. Yeah, we want to stay around 9 strokes on the changes, ideally. And I say that because if you're loading up that blade, you should be dying for a breath at 9. If you're loading up that blade properly, you should be screaming for a breath right? And what I mean by that is, boom, set, right? Quick recovery, you just get a little breath. So on that change, that for me personally, that's when I take that nice deep, like, I need that oxygen breath. You know what I'm saying? So every 9 is ideal. Any questions on that? 2 sides, 7. Nine instead of 15.
Got it.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, that's it for today. Let's go paddle. The workout, we're gonna do a, we're gonna try to line up in crews based on attendance of who's here today. And one thing I do wanna mention is that I will be around after practice just hanging out by my truck. If anybody wants to talk about anything, any questions, just not comfortable with the group, anything paddling related, right? Anything at all. I'm gonna stick around for at least a half an hour after practice if you guys wanna chat, come by. No pressure. Workout today, we're gonna start where we normally start, over there by the bridge. So nice, easy work, warm up. I want you guys to focus on really connecting. So exaggerate on the warm up and the cool down, exaggerate the stroke. 3 inches longer in the front, 3 to 5 inches longer in the back. Okay, so we're really stretching out, really exaggerating on the back. There's a reason for that. I want everybody to get into that habit of pressure all the way through the stroke. Okay, so the stroke rate should be really low, 55, 56. Nice, easy warm up to the bridge. We'll start up, tails on the beach, facing towards the Sheraton. We're gonna go out. First thing we're gonna do a 500 meter piece, zone 3. Right? Zone 3, not max effort like Thursday. Zone 3, what that means is you should be huffing and puffing at the end of this first 500 meter piece. Huffing and puffing, everybody in the boat. And then we're gonna take a little break, recruit. Then we're gonna start a 30 minute piece. We're gonna be heading out towards the jetties. We should be finishing outside of the jetties, heading towards Crystal Pier. Okay, so we make a turn at the pier. We're gonna finish up somewhere off of South Mission Beach, somewhere down there. And then we're gonna regroup, get some water in us, because the next piece is gonna be a 10K. We're going to Crystal Pier. We're gonna high-five the pier, not literally, but we're gonna high-five the pier, make a turn, and we're gonna come straight back. This is just race course review for next weekend. That 10K should finish up somewhere around Paradise Point, maybe a little bit further in the bay, but in this area. And then we're gonna go nice, easy home. So we can stop there, get water, regroup, change seats around at that point if you want to. And then, work on some drills if you want to, steers persons, and then bring everybody home. Is there any questions on the workout?
Yeah, Len. Suggestion, and I don't know, for these long pieces that need boats, they'll get way out front to circle back. Is that when we get to the end, like a 10 minute wave comes up far ahead, or
absolutely. Absolutely. So what's our general rule of thumb? We talked about this in other practices. What's our general rule of thumb, guys? Who wants to go?
500 meters.
There you go. 500 meters. So if the lead boat gets 500 meters out in front, you know, the steers person's got to be looking over their shoulder. Hey, I'm out in front. Okay. You get 5 football lengths, it's gonna be a little bit different for everybody, but if you look back and we look like, we're far behind you, turn around, pick up the last canoe, and come up with that last canoe, right? I want you to get a workout for sure, get that distance in, but go around. We wanna keep as tight together as possible. Good question, Landon. Yes, sir.
At the pier when we turn, that's review.
Yeah.
Turn on the first boat or wait for the first boat?
So if the first boat turns, I wouldn't just start turning then. If you're like the other scenario, because you're way away, right? So what I would do is just keep going until you get within a distance where you judge, okay, they're close enough where I can turn.
Turn with the first boat, not when he turns.
Exactly. Yeah, when the first boat starts to come and meet you, exactly. And that goes for the stragglers in the back. We shouldn't have as much separation as we did last weekend. But in case we do, good question. We have an escort boat today. You guys might recognize our captain. She's our cleat award winner. If you guys weren't here Thursday, All right, any questions? Last time, shots across the bow. All right, let's get into some crews. Can I get all my novices on the right? All the novices on the right.
His right.
Golden masters and above on my left, followed by my senior masters, my 40s, and my open.
You can go either way, Bill.
Golden Masters, over here. Golden Masters in 70s, you guys are together. So, okay, so 50s right here, Senior Masters right here. Landon, Steve, Bruce, 40s. Open, novices. Okay, I like this, all right. Let's start with you guys. Man, we got a shit ton of space persons over here. Feeling it? Okay. Get you guys in there.
I was like, I got something to try it. It tastes good, but I just do pure
caffeine. 40s. Put you over here in this crew with the senior masters. Somebody walked away from that group? Oh, six Randys over there.
Okay. At that age, they meander a lot.
They do, don't they? Okay, you got a steering blade? Okay. You got a steering blade? Okay, there you go. These are your crews. You guys got plenty of steersmen. All right. You guys can decide what you want to do over here. Yeah. All right. Fantastic. All right. Let's get going. I got dibs on the Ale Kanikela today. I'm with you guys.
Okay, of course.